Hey, welcome back. So today I'm going to go over a quick tip. Probably 80% of the time, when the athletes are having different issues with their throws, it really comes down to their posture. All right, so why is posture so important? Well, Javelin is unique in that we have this thing called a runway. And the runway is supposed to allow us or give us space to accelerate. That, of course, is different than shot put. It's different than discus. In those events, you got a very small ring, and so you have to do a lot of creative things in order to generate that acceleration. In the Javelin, it's just us running. Right? It's more complicated than that. But it is really about accelerating. Using the space that you have to accelerate. And posture, to me, is really important because it allows you to accelerate down this runway and be ready to throw so that you don't have to slow down. In fact, you should be able to further accelerate your throw, even coming in really fast on this runway. All right, so when I start talking about posture, I actually start with my feet. I want to make sure that my feet are in the right direction for the throw, in the right direction for running down the runway, to do all of these things to kind of set the body up for the delivery. So for me personally, I'd like to have my feet, of course, my block leg pointing at my target, my right foot, maybe out, maybe about 40, 45 degrees out. And I like to have my hips staggered. I don't want to go sideways here and hide everything. I kind of want to stagger things a little bit, flare that hip, and there's my setup phase to deliver my throw, right? We've kind of gone over this in other videos, so I'm not going to repeat all of those here, but one of the most common things about posture that I think is troublesome is that folks often turn their hips so far back, and then they hinge over. So their rear end is back here, their head is here. In fact, what I often see is that folks are in this position where their head is pushed into the Javelin, and at the last second as they throw and they pull their head away, which leaves the Javelin stranded outside, and now they're coming around the body to throw, and there's a twisting motion. I'm looking for a rolling motion in the direction of my throw. So if this is the direction that I want to be powerful, fast, accelerating, then I want my body to be able to move in that direction, not pulling some other direction. Okay, the second piece about posture is that posture is sort of pre-setting you up to then deliver in those directions. So if I want to throw over the top of my shoulder, I'm going to start it here and I'm going to roll back and then I'm going to roll forward and produce my throw. That orbit right there is really important because it's very efficient. You get the hips moving, you get the shoulders moving, and the Javelin's obviously going to follow in that same direction. So one of the unique things about the Javelin is that we have this runway. And this runway, of course, is unique in, you know, there's no other throwing event that has a runway. What do we use it for? Well, to generate speed. So for us, we're not trying to wrap ourselves up in such a way like a shot putter or a discus thrower might, because they have a limited space to move. Javelin throwers can run really fast and transfer that energy. But if we wrap ourselves up too much, then it kind of limits the ability to convert that energy from the runway into our throw. So for me personally, I like to set up so that my feet are in the right spot, my hips flared a little bit. Posture, my chest is going to be up, but my back is not going to be arching. I think that's the key difference here, is that a lot of folks, when they start seeing folks standing up, is that they start arching their back and getting into this position, and I don't want your back to be arched. I want you to feel like you're in a very strong position to be able to fire off and move into that throw. If your back is arched, this is not a powerful position to be in. In fact, it can be very stressful to a lot of different body parts. So for me, I'm going to flare that hip, chest is going to be up, my head's going to be out of the way, and again, I want to be able to move in the direction of the throw. I'll kind of show you from the rear end and see where things are sort of lined up. Again, my feet, my left foot's at my target, my right foot's about 45 degrees approximately, and as I set up, my right hip is going to be flared, my head's going to be out of the way, so that as I deliver my throw, I'm delivering high over the top in the direction of my throw. It's going to be the same at slow speeds as it is at fast speeds. So if you're doing a standing throw or a three-step, five-step, as you add more steps, the posture doesn't change. In general, you can probably throw farther from a five-step with a lot of wrapping than you could if you sort of stood up with your posture from a five-step. And the reason is we're relying more on that range of motion, the stretching of your muscles in that short range. But when you add a lot of speed down the runway on a full approach, now you're sort of sacrificing some of that range of motion to capture that energy moving down the runway. And so there is kind of a balancing act that has to take place. You know, how much speed can you get while you're under control and convert into the throw? And then how much stretching, how much range of motion can you capture while running as fast as you do down the runway? So there is a bit of a balance. So as we start working on our posture, I think personally, simulated throws help me the very best because I can get many more throwing motions in a short period of time than I could if I grabbed a javelin and started throwing myself. You can also do that indoors. You can do it, you know, between other things that you do during your day. I've got a little bit of rope here just tied off at one end. You can also use like a kitchen towel or some other object. Or you can just do it simulated style without an object. I kind of like this because it gives me an opportunity to kind of hear and see the acceleration as I go through. But again, posture starts with my feet. I'm going to try and get my left foot pointed at my target, my right foot about 40, 45 degrees, and then I'm going to flare that right hip out just a little bit. Again, I'm not arching my back here. I'm just in a standing position, and I just kind of flare that hip, and then I'm going to turn back on it. This feels very powerful to me. I don't feel any strain in my back. I feel like I'm ready to fire into my throw. I like to start off forward and move back, forward, move back, and start creating this orbit that feels really effortless, smooth, efficient. There's a whole bunch of different descriptors we could use, but so I'm going to start off on the front foot. I'm going to swing back, and then I'm going to swing forward. And as you do this, you can start feeling where that orbit feels comfortable. And as you can start moving faster and faster, you can start hearing the whip of that rope. And every single time that I do this, I want to feel like I'm stable. I want my feet to feel like I've got some, you know, something stable that I can build everything on top of. So as you do this, start off slow, start feeling like a smooth motion, and then start accelerating. And again, I'm looking for these long, smooth, efficient movements, and then I start accelerating. All right, next piece. So the crossover, that's the important part for me. The crossover, as you've seen in other videos that I've created, is that the crossover for me is the setup of the throw. In baseball, they might call it a crow hop. There might be other sports that do sort of a setup phase before a strike. In the javelin, it's a three-step or a crossover. Some people also call it the impulse step. That's the key for me. It's the setup of my throw. The setup is necessary because as I'm bringing more speed down the runway, potentially there's more to set up. If I'm out of position coming down really, really fast, that means I have smaller and smaller amounts of time to make the adjustment to be ready for the throw. So as I do a crossover, I'm looking to get into that throwing position early on in the process, and I want to maintain it. So a lot of people, as they move through their crossover, they're going to cross and they're going to sink down and they're going to hinge over their right side. And what that does is it forces them to then open up at the last second in order to produce their throw. And it's a big motion done in a very short period of time, depending on how fast you're moving down the runway. The way I look at doing a crossover is not sacrificing the speed and sacrificing that setup, by just doing it earlier. So instead, I'm going to flare that hip a little bit, knowing what my standing throw position kind of supposed to look like. I'm going to flare that hip a little bit, and as I go through my crossover, I'm going to cross and maintain that position here, so when I land, I'm immediately ready to fire instead of further setting up when you land on your right foot. All right, thanks for watching. Appreciate that. If you don't mind, hit that subscribe button and the bell notification, so each time I upload a new video, you'll get notified. And for now, I guess have fun and throw far.